the Allied fighters, Spitfires, three of them, and one Hurricane, came from the RAF's Battle of Britain flight, later the Battle of Britain Memorial flight. Others came from civilian owners in the UK, and in the case of one of the Hurricanes, in Canada. But the enemy aircraft were a different matter. A certain number of original enemy aircraft types formed part of the RAF's collection for museum display purposes. Flying sequences. An aircraft with a great combat history of its own, quite a part. Very active in Spanish West Africa, conducting strafing and rocket attacks and also escort sorties. They also engaged in counterinsurgency work of Spanish territory in the Sahara. But they really, as a result of Battle of Britain, have become known as one of the quintessential movie aircraft, quite apart from their role in Battle of Britain. Some of them were to have played P-51 Mustangs, of all things, in a film called Patton. They wore RAF markings for a rather low-rent Italian production called Eagles Over London. And when Airworthy Buchon started flying again in Europe in 1980, they took part in London's then television and invented Bell. And all the while being filmed by the garishly painted B-25 Mitchell camera ship, the psychedelic monster. Thank you. 68 with us, John Creech's time. And don't forget, this was at the time in 1968, the filming took place, when the Warbird movement, as we know it today, was very much in its infancy. There were very few privately owned historic aircraft available for displays. There's absolutely no doubt whatsoever that the Battle of Britain helped kickstart it, to kickstart the interest, the enthusiasm, and the injection such as Duxford. Outstanding locations for the flying of warbirds to this day. That is one of Battle of Britain's